drop it.
And you must be Mr. Yoon.
And how do you know that? Or the one wonton among the tortillas?
I would have said kimchi and the salsa.
That's good. See, the Hannigan were slaves from Korea brought over to Mexico to work in plantations.
I know.
And some people think that I'll be offended if you point out the incongruity.
Well, I assume you want it pointed out.
And why would I want that?
Because it suggests you're very good at what you do.
I think Mr. Picker told you we require payment up front.
He did, but we were hoping to come to a different understanding.
What the hell is this, Boyd? I gave these guys
We've had some bad experiences lately with the pay up front business model.
Well, fortunately, the people I represent rely on me precisely because they know I'm not like them. I dislike beheadings, gentlemen.
So do we.
It's bad for business. And the fact is, money in that bag would only buy you insurance against my employers feeling taken advantage of if anything should go wrong in our transaction. So I'm willing to proceed without it. I do want to make sure you understand that my employers will never let anything jeopardize their reputation as men not to be crossed. And if at any point their reputation needs to be reestablished, it won't be me they send.
Oh, speaking of, have you ever seen the show Boardwalk Empire?
Sure.
Okay. You know how they always got these, like, naked chicks walking around, right? Like the whores at the brothel or the girls at Buscemi's fucking, right? Have you noticed that all of them are rocking these giant bushes? It's like a straight up jungle down there.
I'm pretty sure that's how women looked back then.
Yeah, but these are beautiful women played by modern day actresses. And they're way too vain and shallow to let themselves just go like that, no matter how committed they are. And frankly, how committed are you going to get playing a whore in a brothel, right? No. And plus, these actresses have boyfriends or husbands or whatever. You get what I'm saying here? You think a guy who can land a Hollywood actress wants to chow down on something that resembles a Brillo pad? No freaking way, man! So I have to think that all these girls are rocking the merkin.
Rocking the what? What is it?
It's a pubic wig. A fake glued on bush.
How do you know these things? I'm sure you're right. I'm sure that's what happened.
Here's the part that really gets me, okay? If all these women are rocking the merkin, that means there is somebody on that set that has to glue that shit on in the morning and take that off at the end of the day. If you're that kind, what do you even tell people when they ask you what your job is? Or hey, my name is Bob and I glue on fake hair on actresses' ranch, right? And what do you even get credited as? Are you the Bushmaster? And how much money does a Bushmaster actually make? And more importantly, how do I get that job?
What are you working for?
What? No.
What are you working for?
No, I no. No,
please. Stop. You made a mistake. What are you working for?
No one.
No, she's not lying.
No.
How do you know she's not lying to us?
No, you're making a mistake.
To kill Mr. Yoon's daughter?
No.
Fucking lie to me. She's my parole officer, okay?
Look, she's already seen our face. We let her go. Yoon comes after us.
I won't say anything.
She didn't do anything, okay?
I swear. I won't
okay,
say anything.
You got a family.
Just put the gun down.
Are you Sean Lu?
Yes. Hey, Brian. I want you to go down in the hall and do this 10 more times, okay? Now go below. I take it you're not here to check for my permits.
Your father was found dead this morning.
How?
He was shot. His body was recovered in the mountains north of here.
Why would someone do this?
When was the last time you saw him?
Yesterday. He took the boat out for a short run and got into some nice fish that I took to market.
Did you notice anything that was out of the ordinary?
Yeah. I found my laptop on. The only reason I noticed because I checked the weather first thing. My pops was old school. No cell phone, no computers. Only surfing he did was on a longboard.
What can you tell me about the altercation your father had?
He wouldn't tell me. My father didn't want me to get involved. Said he was taking care of it.
In all my years of doing business, this is a first. And I don't mean that in a good way.
I Mr. Yoon, I want to apologize for this unfortunate set of circumstances.
Your cousin here claims he has vast resources at his disposal, to the tune of almost 40,000 a kilo.
You got $1 million shoved up your ass?
He says he can have it here with a simple phone call.
If I hear a deal is too good to be true, more often than not, it's too good to be true.
It's not just the heroin, Boyd. No, I'm spending my money on something else.
Oh, yeah? What, is he gonna give you a reach around?
I'm buying your life.
Mr. Yoon, we had a deal. Now, I understand your Mexican cartels have a reputation, but let me tell you something, so do the rednecks in Kentucky.
Well, I'm willing to take that risk. But until that briefcase arrives, I won't be taking any. Now, if his money is good, I'm going with him. If he can't deliver, then I'll take yours.